All right, everybody, we'll lead off with linebacker Jaden Yates, tied for the team lead in tackles with 20. And he might know a thing or two about Columbus eateries if you all are trying to roll up there this week.
Jaden, just talk about the excitement level. I know you're from right there. You know what Ohio State football is. Talk a little bit about your enthusiasm as you head to Saturday.
I mean, obviously, for one reason or another, me and everybody's kind of excited, ready to go. I start team-wise, I mean, like you said, I quote-unquote big game. But, I mean, I think important thing is to just kind of next game on a schedule mentality. I mean, all it is another Saturday, whether it's at 12, whether it's in Columbus, whether it's in Arkansas. I mean, it's just another Saturday game that everybody's kind of looking forward to. Me in particular, on a personal level, you know, I'm from there, Columbus. You know, I've been around the Ohio State kind of fandom for a couple years now. So, I mean, it's always fun going back home. I'm sure there'll be a lot of faces in the stands that I'm pretty familiar with, a lot of faces on the other sideline I'm familiar with. But, yeah, just kind of staying in that mentality of just another game, man. Another opportunity for us to go and create value for ourselves, another opportunity for us to go play the game we love. So everybody's excited.
You know, obviously, these first couple games, there have been some good moments on defense for you guys. I know you kind of worked your way into that starting spot. You know, paid your dues on special teams last year. Just how much have you know these first couple weeks of the season meant to you personally to get that playing time and kind of show what you're made of out there?
I mean, me personally, kind of like you said, it was always about getting my foot in the door at first. I mean, special teams definitely played a big part in that for me last year. It's just I found the hardest part for a lot of people is just getting on the field initially. So for me to be able to use special teams last year as a way to kind of springboard myself into a position to now be able to come in and fight for that starting spot definitely meant a lot. But the success that I have had these last couple of games, the success as a defense that we've had, like you said, I mean, it's kind of, I don't want to say expected, but we put all the work in, working for the last 19 years of your life at a certain goal, at a certain craft. I mean, if you don't reap the rewards at some point, you know, it's kind of like, well, dang. So I feel like the success we've had as a unit, success we've had as a team, success I've had in particular, I feel like it's coming at a time that it needs to come. It's coming at a time that people have kind of expected us to be able to have success on our side of the ball as we have in the past couple of years.
When you look at Ohio State offensively, what stands out to you as far as what they're doing, or is there anyone in particular that's caught your attention as you look at them?
I mean, you know, obviously Ohio State's a big brand of football. I mean, they got some guys from top to the bottom of their roster that at any given play, any given moment can do some special things with the ball. I feel like a big part that we need to do in order to get comfortable settling into the game is kind of understand that. I feel like a big thing for me in this whole underdog type game is really just understanding that, come to terms with a lot of the realities that can end up happening. Reality is they're, I guess, whatever, supposed to be bigger, faster, stronger. Another reality is that we got some guys on our side of the ball too that work just as hard, if not harder, that just as talented, if not more talented. So I mean, give props where it's due, but at the end of the day, I know I feel like with this team, with this unit that we have, everybody got to spot the ball, you know. Got to play first, second, third, fourth down. You know, kind of just get to come out there and I guess, for lack of a better term, simulate the game. You know, you still got to play at the end of the day. You still got to play ball.
I think back to National Signing Day when it was the first time you talked to us and you kind of said you wanted to make your own, you know, footprint here at Marshall. You know, obviously what your dad has done has been well documented, but having that support from that family here when you're playing, you know, whether it's on the road or here, just how much does that mean to have, you know, his support and just kind of let you become your own player?
Yeah, you know, obviously, I mean, I knew what I was kind of getting into going into it. Obviously, Pops played up here. He did a lot of great things, had a lot of success. But having him in my corner as a support system to kind of lean on, having mom, little sister, you know, everybody around in the building to kind of lean on as a support system, you know, it makes things a little easier to deal with. At the end of the day, you know, I can't rely on his first or last name. You know, I got to, at the end of the day, I'm putting on the helmet, I'm putting on the shoulder pads. I'm the one who's going out there making calls, making plays. I mean, this ain't what, 1998, whenever he played anymore, it's 2024, you know? So I mean, there's some definitely some things that I go to him. Hey, however this play, you know, how I think I should play that. But at the end of the day, it's all about me and the guys I'm with on the field. That's the only things I could really focus on. But I definitely do appreciate, you know, having people to be able to lean on when things might get a little tough or whatever.
You know, it's about their running backs, be it Judkins or Henderson or people. They keep coming. But anything that stands out specifically to you about them?
I mean, those guys are great players, kind of like what I said earlier. I mean, from top down, from their whole roster, you know, they got a lot of great guys, and specifically the backs. I mean, those are NFL guys. You can see those guys on Sundays. So, I mean, I feel like it's a great challenge. It's a great way to measure where me personally I'm at with my game, but also a great way to measure as a defensive unit where we're at. You know, we pride ourselves on a lot of things as a defense, and I feel like this week is a great test to really see what we're made of with a couple of guys, that 1-2 punch that they got, that, like I said, you'll see on Sundays.
You know, there's no doubt that the Shoe is one of the best environments in college football. You know, having just been at Virginia Tech, you know, does that kind of, you know, let you guys hone in on that mentality? Hey, we've got an opportunity to, you know, the eyes of the nation are on us right now. We've got an opportunity to go create value for ourselves. Just walk me through the mentality of you know, going out there each and every day, no matter the venue, no matter how many people are in the stands.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like you could look at it one of two ways. You know, when you're said to be an underdog, whether it be in any aspect of life, a sport, whatever it may be, you could fall into the hype to whereas, and whatever the spread or the media has us to lose by however many points, you could look at it that way, or you could look at it, like you said, as an opportunity to create value for yourself as individually, as a player, as a unit, as a side of the ball, as a team. So I feel like that's really important for us to make sure we're in the right headspace going into this game, that everybody has the right mindset, everybody's on board, that, I mean, they don't turn the scoreboard on for no reason. You know, they ain't turn the scoreboard on for us to come out there and let them run all over us. You know, you still got to spot the ball, still got to play ball at the end of the day. So I think it's really important for us to be in the right headspace, mentality, everything like that, as there's going to be a lot of eyes on this game, a lot of spectators, but also a lot of eyes from the next level. You know, whoever they might have came to look for, whoever they might be there to see, by default, they got to see all 22 on the field, you know. So if things going your way, guys get hot, guys start making plays, got to come on your best, you know, your A game. Going to be a lot of feel, a lot of money to be made out there.
Anything further for Jaden? All right, thanks very much, Jaden.
Appreciate you.
Obviously, coming off an off week, after you play two games, you've kind of seen both ends of the spectrum talent-wise. You know, what does that do for a team going into a bye week before you head into another game?
Really motivate us, see what we got on our team, the depth.
We've been asking everybody, coach included, about going to Ohio State. You were at Tech a few weeks ago. It's going to be a great atmosphere, a lot of people, eyes of the nation will be watching. How much does that inspire you guys and get you motivated?
It gets us motivated very well because everybody want to be able to take that next opportunity at the high level. So, yeah, feeling the environment, the crowd.
You know, when you look at the pieces of the secondary, obviously there were a couple questions coming into the year, but you guys have really you know, played well in passing down situations and been able to make some plays back there. What's the chemistry like back there, and what do you think has worked well so far this year?
The chemistry very well. Everybody, like, joining together. We clicking, we bonding, getting extra work outside of it, watching film, and it's just been going good.
Speaking of that film, what do you see from Ohio State? What's the challenge for them? You know, what stands out or who stands out?
They very simple. They just got the right players, elite players. So we just got to emphasize on doing everything right.
You know, obviously, you know, this will be the third game of a four-game non-conference schedule. How much of what happens out there, you know, in your non-conference schedule is helping you guys build towards the team you need to be when conference play comes?
It do a good job. Like, the transporter is real, so it's like a lot of players everywhere, and our, like, conference come out everywhere. So it's not really a big difference, but it is because the name.
Any other questions? All right, thank you.
Appreciate it.
Yeah, Stone, we talked after the Virginia Tech game. You're just about the environment, you know, another good environment coming up. Does that experience, having played in an environment like that, kind of give you an idea of what to expect and how to level out emotions and handle yourself in a situation like that?
Yeah, I would say definitely, just because the last 2 weeks, it was a very big crowd, a very loud environment, and it just kind of prepares us that, okay, we've been here once now, let's go do it this time and just execute at a higher level. So it was good to get our feet wet in an environment like that, and I'm looking forward to this week.
How have you used the time off between games? What have you been working on specifically just to get better, you know, and how beneficial was it to have that time?
It was very beneficial. Last week we kind of focused on the little things, the little technique that will separate us from our opponents. So just being able to kind of go day by day and then focus on just our small plays that we work on, just the plays we have every day that we know we can execute. And then as this week comes around, just getting that connection right with those specific plays and the people we have in that position, just getting that connection right and then, you know, just executing and going into this week. That's a big thing to have. So we're excited for this week for sure.
When you look at Ohio State, who or what stands out to you when you look at them on film?
I mean, well, their defense obviously stands out. You know, obviously they're extremely athletic team, a big team, and one of the best defenses in the country. So we know what we're walking into, and we're very excited to kind of show what we can do. And, I mean, this is one of those games where you dream about as a little kid. So just God has blessed us with this great opportunity to have. So,
with that, Stone, I know you almost have to go a little quicker against a team that's got that much talent on defense. But how do you do it and not be in too much of a hurry where you just got to make sure you make your plays a little quicker because they're going to be coming?
Yeah, especially at the quarterback position, I like the saying where you got to be fast down low, but slow up top in the mind. You can't let the game get to you. You got to trust your training. You got to fall back to the level of your training is what I like to emphasize whenever I'm going to a big game like this. And just know that, like, it's just a game. Just have fun with it. Control what you can control. Don't try to not make mistakes. Just let the big plays come to you. And at the end of the day, good things will happen.
You know, obviously with two games under your belt and now a week to kind of process those two games, you know, are you feeling more comfortable out there in the offense? You know, I know the air raid system is a lot about timing, and trying to build that chemistry in game can be tough, but are you feeling more comfortable out there?
I definitely feel a lot more comfortable just being able to get that connection down with the receivers in game, because it's different than practice and then extra throwing sessions and whatnot, but just being able to especially go into the first game and then the second game where you're kind of thrown out there against a big-time opponent like that. And, you know, we showed a lot of great things on tape, but we also missed a lot of things that we know we should have made. So just extremely thankful to have this great opportunity in front of us to show that, you know, we corrected the things that we've been working on and go out there and just have fun and execute.
Obviously, lots of weapons on the offensive side, but that tight end room can be sneaky good sometimes, even if they're not catching the ball. Just how much do they add to the offense, whether it's, you know, running routes or whether it's, you know, protection-wise?
I mean, they play a huge role, especially just being a security blanket, and then, like, we have some guys that can make plays down the field, as long with small plays where you get the ball to them and they make somebody miss or get those tough yards that we need. And then in protection game, like, they play a huge role in with the O-line and then what we have to do in the passing game. So just knowing that we're taken care of in that standpoint and that we don't really – like, I know with those guys and any of those guys, I don't have to really worry about protection because I know they're going to do their job.
Anything further for Stone?
Thank you, guys. You have a good one.
All right, everyone. Next, we got offensive lineman Jalen Slappy.
How's everybody doing?
Also Columbus native.
Yeah.
Might have gone to the same school as a guy named Kenzie that you all covered for a long time, too, right?
Yes, sir.
The more you know. you know, obviously a big opportunity in front of you guys this week. Just how excited are you, you know, to get up there to Columbus? And I guess it's a little bit of a homecoming for you, too. How excited are you to get up there and play?
I'm really excited. Honestly, never thought I'd be playing against, like, my hometown really like that. But I'm really excited. It's just another opportunity to compete, man. I feel like they got great guys. I like our guys, too. But just another opportunity to compete. I know a lot of guys on the team, so it's going to be fun for sure.
Anybody specific you could talk about you know on the team?
The Styles brothers, I played Little League with them. Little League. Some of the D-linemen, they went to Pick Central, Pick North. I didn't really know them, but they're, like, in the community, so, like, I know a lot of them, really. So,
how would you describe that defense?
I think they really have a good defense. They play four down, base four down. They try to win with their base four down. I don't think they do a lot of blitzes, stunts, none of that. They just try to win. But like I said, we've been in the work all week. We still got more work to put in. I just believe in us, really. So,
is there anybody on that unit that you could just look at maybe that stands out to you, or is there a couple of guys that maybe stand out more to you? And there's a lot of talent there.
I think they all really stand out. I mean, we are playing a Big Ten school, really. Like I said, I think their D-line is the best group. It's going to be a challenge for us, O-line coming in. I feel like I still like our guys, though, but it's going to be a good competitive series for sure, though.
So should we assume you were an Ohio State fan growing up, or sort of? So what's that like now? You're going to go into that atmosphere, and you know the dot in the I and, you know, the whole, you know, Brutus and all the traditions. Is that something that you're fired up about, obviously?
Yeah, I'm definitely fired up about it. I was like, when you live in Columbus, you're like forced to kind of be an Ohio State fan, really. My dad really never liked Ohio State. He was he liked the team up north, so it was like, yeah, it's a long story. But, yeah, it's definitely going to be exciting for sure. Yeah.
I mean, now you're walking in with a big M on your chest, so.
Yeah. It's been like that all my life, but.
You know, this offensive line group obviously looks very different from a year ago. Mm-hmm. You know, but you're one of those pieces that kind of got some valuable reps toward the end of last year. And just how have you used that to kind of build, you know, your own knowledge of the offense as they've made this switch and just, you know, what's working out there for you guys as a unit?
Yeah. I got reps, started like four games last year. I feel like it helped me a lot. I had a lot of older guys to help me out last year, Don Tucker, Ethan Driscoll, a lot of those guys. But Trent Holler, he left, he transferred. But I just feel like it got me ready for this year. I am the youngest out of the whole line. They're all 6 years. So, but I feel like the things they taught me, the things they left me with last year, I feel like I'm in the spot that I need to be right now. That's what I feel like.
With the week off, a lot of time to maybe work on yourself, prepare a little bit more. Yeah, what kind of progress do you think that your unit's made with this extra time?
I feel like the progress we made was really just the communication level, and honestly, just playing for us, really, because that's the whole line. Like, it's really up to us up front. As long as we play for us and we know each other and we trust each other, I feel like we can do really special things this year.
And obviously, last year. You know, sacks were a little bit of a problem sometimes, but you guys have only given up two to start this year in the first two games. And, you know, just how much of a confidence boost is that kind of a start and, you know, just, you know, taking pride in doing your job and hanging on for just long enough for the quarterback to get the ball out?
Yes, sir. I feel like it's definitely a big confidence boost. I feel like what we think is not to just hold on as long as the quarterback can throw. I feel like our mind is telling us, like, just block the guy in front of you, like, really. I feel like our two sacks we gave up, some were on me, but I took all responsibility for it. But I feel like we just keep getting better, man. That's all, really. I feel like last year's O-line, we wasn't really connected as we should have, even though with the older guys and stuff like that. But this year, I feel like we, like I said, play for each other a lot, so.
Did they ever pick on you for being the youngest up there?
Yeah, they do that a lot. I always call them old and all of that, but, yeah, you know, I'm going to get there.
But when you're playing beside some of those guys with a lot of that college football experience, yeah. You know, some of them here, some of them transferred from other schools, mm-hmm. just how much of a resource are they to you?
A big resource. Like, they know things. They tell me things to relax, stop playing so hyper, really just relax and have fun with the game. I feel like that's one thing I've been working on this bye week and this year, is to have fun playing the game. Because last year I was a freshman playing so timid or like just playing nervous. I feel like this year, like, I just got to be comfortable and just not play, like, just have fun, really, because I've been playing this since I was little, really, so.
Anything further for Slappy? All right, everybody, thank you all for being patient. We've got wide receiver Christian Fitzpatrick. You might have seen him on a couple highlights over the last couple weeks. 21.3 yards per catch so far this season. Questions?
Well, how many times have you rewatched that catch, and how many times have you shown Dobson?
Yeah, no, definitely. I definitely had my moment, you feel me, take it all in. I definitely wasn't looking past that catch, you know, after the game. Definitely not the outcome we wanted, but it was definitely a cool experience to see me everywhere, you feel me. Definitely my pops keeps me updated, sending me the videos that's coming up on ESPN and everything like that, that you got Moss, so it was definitely dope.
You know, when you look at what worked well for the offense, because there were moments it looked good, you know, the play was right, the positioning was right, just lacking execution in a few areas. How much did this off week kind of help you guys, you know, hone in on some of those timing routes and things like that?
Mm-hmm, definitely. We definitely cleaned a lot of things up over the bye week, because definitely how you execute a bye week can, like, speak a lot on what type of team you have and, you know, what's going to happen moving forward. You know, Coach Huff definitely kept us, you know, here and now, you feel me, not looking forward. You know, bye week, it was Marshall versus Marshall. So we was definitely honing in on everything like that.
Well, this week it's Marshall versus Ohio State. How excited are you just to go out there again against a really top opponent?
Mm-hmm, yeah, I'm very excited. I love when, you know, it's guys out there who, you know, have some notable, you know, accolades and everything like that. I love when the competition is at the highest, for sure.
When you look at them, anything stand out to you, anything in particular that they do well or that caught your attention?
Mm-hmm. I would say, to be honest, them boys, they seem a little physical, for sure. They seem more physical this year at the line of scrimmage and, you know, just throughout play, you know, getting off blocks. The whole team, they shed blocks very well. So, you know, it'll be definitely a key to really hold on to your block, you know, play through the whistle and everything like that. You know, they got all ball players, all great players over there. So it should be a good one for sure.
At MSU, Christian, did you get a chance to play there at Ohio State?
Yes, sir.
And obviously, do you tell your guys what to expect, or at least kind of clue them in on what it's going to be like?
Uh-huh, yeah, most definitely. I haven't as of late, but, you know, obviously on a big, you know, a big stage, you know, week three, definitely, like, on the schedule, already coming here, I already knew it was on the schedule. So, like, through spring, through summer, you know, not necessarily looking ahead, but, you know, just a little tips here, a little experience here, you know, just letting them boys know, you feel me, like, what to expect, what's ahead, you know, for the season as a whole. You just got to be prepared. You got to be training your mind, even, you know, January 1st, you know what I'm saying? So definitely had a couple talks with some guys.
You know, you talked about their physicality, but you kind of strike me as a guy who probably takes that on as a challenge. You know, when a secondary is physical like that, you know, how much more challenging does that make your job as a receiver to get where you need to be?
I would say it does in a way, but, you know, a guy like you said, of my stature and everything like that, I accept the challenge always. You know, I always say, you know, like, on a Saturday, I'm coming into a fight. You know, it's not a football game, it's a fight. Especially nowadays, you know, it's definitely a lot of hand grabbing, a lot of pushing and tugging. So, like, you know, you got to always be prepared to, you know, get somebody up off you and pull yourself through, do little things like that. You know, a lot of things that come, like, with a little tips and tricks, like, it just comes from experience. Because, you know, it's hard to replicate, you know, necessarily on a Saturday how the game's going to be called. You know, you got to get a feel for it the first drive and see how the refs going to allow you and the DBs to play for the whole game.
You obviously have a lot of confidence. In a game like that, do you feel like if it's one-on-one, throw me the ball and I'll go get it? Is it as simple as that kind of confidence?
Oh, yes, sir. All the time, you know. all the time. Every Saturday I feel that way, and that's how you got to approach the game always. You always got to come, especially as a receiver, you got to definitely feel like you're the best player out there. You got to have some swag to you, some oomph, because, you know, if you don't, at the end of the day, like, they're going to smell it on you too. You feel me? So you got to always feel like, you know, I'm that guy, and, you know, throw me the ball. And whenever it's in the air, you got to, you know, go ahead and make a play on it.
Your coach talked about the ability for you guys to put pressure on a team like Ohio State. When you look back at that Virginia Tech film, you know, that second drive, you move the ball well, have a chance to score, you know, obviously miss the field goal. But how important will those first couple of drives be to be able to kind of get established in that environment and have a chance to quiet down the crowd?
Most definitely. The first couple of drives will definitely be key, just to set the tempo, set the atmosphere that we're here to definitely play a real football game. You know what I'm saying? You got to get them boys out their comfort zone. You got to force the play callers to, you know, call plays that, you know, got to get them out of situations. We want to make them uncomfortable, and that's kind of what we were missing versus Virginia Tech, for sure.
Anything further for Fitz?